See, we give in life. I call it the quadrant. You have your business, you have your health, you have your lifestyle, and you have your relationships. And what we do is, because we're so driven, we forget about our health.
Hi, this is Ford Saeks, the CMO of the Global Leaders Organization and host of the GLO Show, your source for insights from business leaders and entrepreneurs around the globe. I recently met with Mark McDonald, world-renowned nutrition and fitness expert, best-selling author, and international speaker, teacher, and trainer. Mark has coached everyone from celebrities to business executives to soccer moms. And he is the founder of Venice Nutrition and the reason why I weigh 10 pounds lighter today than I did from this interview. Mark and I explored how entrepreneurs can be health conscious while managing their businesses, as well as creating an organization that values health and fitness. Mark also shared how he became an entrepreneur, what led to his passion for fitness, and some easy tips to get entrepreneurs like you healthy and active. This interview changed the way I look, act, and feel, and I continue to grow. And I'm excited to share it with you today. So when did you first get the entrepreneurial bug?
You know, I think it came back to myself as an athlete, as grown up, soccer player, and I kept thinking about how can I get that competitive edge? And I could never find it. So even though I got a full scholarship, I played college, I played pro, I could never find that one thing. So when I started seeing there was a missing gap in the nutrition field, I became an entrepreneur that moment. And when I was 16 years old, I think my first job, I worked for Long's Drugs. And I didn't like the structure as much. I like to kind of feel like I have a vision.
Right.
So I think I've been an entrepreneur my whole life. I grew up watching my dad as an entrepreneur too. But the biggest thing why I wanted to become a health expert is to make a difference in the world and lead a movement with that.
So obviously in your field, right? Yeah. Just like any business owner, there's a lot of competition.
Yeah.
I mean, especially in fitness and nutrition, right?
Yeah.
So what do you do to stand out above the competition? So what can businesses do to stand out above the competition?
Yeah, I think the most important thing is you gotta lead with your heart. So for me, I grew up watching my mom as a chronic dieter. So I knew there was a hole somewhere because the dieting industry is designed to have people fail. You go in all for a moment, you get a result, life pushes back, and then you regain everything. You know, when I finished playing soccer, I put on 60 pounds in 6 months. I went on what I call the pizza diet. And because I was exercising so much when I played, and then once I stopped playing, I wasn't exercising as much anymore. And I realized that there had to be a better way, because right after that, I went on a ketogenic diet. I took my body fat down to 4% and lived as a fitness model in LA for 2 years, looking amazing and feeling horrible. And in 1999, I said, wait, there's gotta be a better way. There's gotta be a way where you can end this dieting madness and teach people how to win. So as an entrepreneur, it's about having a vision. It's about being passionate of what you're doing and then giving to people and leading with your heart. And if you can start with that, if you can start with a passion and the power and understand that and a vision of where you want to go, that's your first step.
So business owners can do that for anything, right?
Yeah.
So people, members of Global Leaders Organization, GLO, they can apply the same things that you're talking about to all areas of their life, right?
Yeah, that's why I love GLO. That's why I love the Global Leaders, because what I feel as a health expert, so I'm an expert in one category.
Right.
But the country, our movement, the world is all about entrepreneurship. It's about people believing in something bigger than themselves and driving that. So whether it's someone who's a sleep expert or someone who loves empowering finances or small business, whatever field it may be in, it's just having a story that drives them to be passionate, because we live in a world now with social media and with everything out there that people, they don't follow companies as much as they follow movements. They follow they follow heart. And if you have that, if you have that passion, you can do anything.
So you mentioned your story. So myself, I was a former speed skater and a cyclist, and I was 168. And then I went to business, and I went to 268. Now I'm on my way back down. So what's a tip that you can give an entrepreneur that uses an excuse like I would use, you know, approach avoidance or procrastination or just traveling? Like I'm always saying, I travel so much, it's hard to find good food. Well, you know, a lot of our listeners and viewers travel a lot, or they have work that they're trying to do. So how do they balance nutrition and a busy lifestyle?
You know, that's why I love the partnership with Microsoft as well when we talk about with GLO, and talking about, I'm going to cover three things in my presentation today. But the biggest thing for me was this. I remember having a conversation with my mom. I'm 46, and my mom and I were talking, and my dad passed away a few years ago. Mm-hmm. But when he was 45, his health, he was an entrepreneur, mm-hmm. and his health started to slide because what he focused on more was his business and not his health. See, we give in life, I call it the quadrant. You have your business, you have your health, you have your lifestyle, and you have your relationships. And what we do is, because we're so driven, we forget about our health. We forget about the little stuff. So I always think about the 1%. Imagine as an entrepreneur mm-hmm. right now, wherever you sit, 1% health improvement, whether that's walking 5 more minutes a day, whether it's as you're sitting at a stool like Ford and
right.
putting your shoulders back, tightening your core, these little 1% improvements, just like in a business,
right.
the 1% improvements, imagine a year from now, every day your business growing 1%, the compound effect of that. Your health is the same way. You have to remember what you get from your health. I'm a dad, I have a 3-year-old daughter, I have a 13-year-old son, I've been with my wife since college. So it's not about what I look in the mirror or the scale,
right.
it's about how great I can be in my life. And that's what you have to keep remembering. As you live your dream with your business, it's also remembering why your health matters.
So thinking about your business, what obstacles had you overcome, not in the health part, but how did you handle adversity or failure? Have you experienced that in the growth of your business? And tell me a little about that.
I mean, I think the hardest thing as an entrepreneur is how do you duplicate beyond yourself? So for me, we launched our company, Venice Nutrition, in 1999 in Venice Beach. Okay. And as long as I was working with someone, it was, we were rocking.
Right,
we
right.
got 6 practices. Everything was basically in our control. We were doing big workplace wellness. But you're only as good as your time. So the challenge as an entrepreneur is there's only 24 hours in a day. Time is our greatest commodity.
Right.
So what I realized is I was in Valencia, California at that time. We're traveling to Venice Beach, commuting, and my wife Abby said, "Hey, I want to have let's have a child." And I said, "Well, that's not the type of dad I want to be. I don't want to work 15 hours a day."
Right.
So I said, "How do I duplicate myself?" So I partnered with some of my great health professionals, a couple doctors, dietitian. We formed our own medical board. We created our own nutrition certification. And we launched our own health professional division teaching people. And now we have over 30,000 certified nutritionists. So part of the process was, number one, feeling like I was very successful in hitting a wall and not knowing what to do. And I had to duplicate myself. Then the other mistake I made, so that was going.
So duplicate yourself.
Duplicate yourself, but this is the thing. You can't remove yourself from the equation.
Right.
So what I thought was, if I duplicate myself, then I can just kind of not lead it as much.
Right.
And other people can just lead it. The problem though as an entrepreneur is that a community wants people to, you want to empower everyone to be leaders. But at the end of the day, if you have the vision, you have to keep sharing that vision.
Right.
And that's so what I realized, I couldn't remove myself from the equation, but I could keep myself in it. So I had to duplicate myself, still share the vision, and develop other leaders.
So kind of hire your weaknesses, right?
Exactly.
So you got to focus on your strengths, but you need to hire your weaknesses so that you can still be you, but yet you can get them to be inspired to follow your vision.
Exactly. And then the third thing that we started focusing on was just making sure that we can make a difference in people's lives and continue to speak to other audiences. So originally, we were helping people who wanted to lose that last 10 pounds.
Right.
Then we started helping people who were chronic dieters. Then we started working with athletes. So it was a diversifying it so that our mission is simple. We want to educate the world on how to balance your blood sugar so you can win with your health forever, so you can truly live your best health. So it was diversifying our offerings, getting smarter, getting sharper, understanding the power of social media and leveraging the tools to our advantage, and then empowering other coaches on how to do that.
So I know that you've got this eight week challenge, which of course I'm signing up for, and I'd encourage all of you to sign up for the 8-week challenge. So this is the before picture, everybody, and then we can see, is this the real deal? Am I really gonna do this?
Yes, but Ford is going to.
Yeah, so I'm signing up for this, so I encourage all of you to check that out too. But so tell me, what is an organization? So you take a company that might have 3 people to 3,000 people, right? How important is it for a company to encourage their employees to be healthy? Like obviously, common sense, you would say yes, but a lot of companies think, well, that's not part of my leadership. But don't you think that it should be part of the culture?
Yeah, I think everything rises and falls with leadership. That's why I love GLO, because it's a whole thing is about, it's a global leader organization.
Right.
And it partners with incredible companies like Microsoft and other companies to really deliver that message. The challenge is that a lot of times we think we need to lead by fear. I'm not a fan of that. You know, if someone has high blood sugar or they have cholesterol problems, no one really makes change because of fear. People make change because of inspiration and motivation. So the challenge ends up being, it's like kids, for example. If a kid is unhealthy, but the parents are unhealthy, it doesn't solve anything. So as a business leader, you always start with you. And then if you are living it, then you create this culture of health. Now, why does a company need a culture of health? Mm-hmm. As we've done workplace wellness for multiple years around the world, is number one, it makes people feel better. Number two, it creates greater energy. It creates a greater culture, community. It creates a more passionate people because they feel like you're living life. I think right now, too many people accept average health. They talk about, well, I'm good for 30, or I'm good for 40, or I'm good for 50. That's horrible. Like,
right, the, end right. Of the low 46, standard, right?
Yeah, my standard, I want to be the best. I might not recover like when I was 20, but I can still play basketball with my son. Right. I can still do indoor trampoline, dodgeball. I can still play semi-pro soccer. So it's about being your best. And as a company, when you create this culture of health, everything is greater. Productivity. It's not about working longer hours. It's about working smarter hours.
So what's one or two tips that a viewer could take away? If you're a business owner, leader, entrepreneur, what's something that they could do this week? Like, what? Give me one or two tips that they could do this week to start on the road. Of course, other than signing up for the 8-week health challenge, which we'll put a link down here. We'll be able to do that. But what's one or two things that you would tell a company? Obviously, it starts with them. You just said it starts with the leader at the top. What's the next thing that they can do today, or what's the first thing that they should do?
Yeah, so I think there's three main things to do.
Okay.
Number one, so it starts with you, but you got to start with your own mindset.
Yeah, go ahead.
Instead of thinking about focusing on big changes, think about one thing that you can do every single day. So instead of taking the elevator, you walk the stairs.
So walk the stairs,
walk
okay.
Walk the stairs, but then challenge your entire culture to walk the stairs. So that would be your theme. Walk the stairs, let's ditch the elevator.
All right.
Okay. Number two would be food. So while we talk about something called PFC every three, eating a balance of protein, fats, and carbohydrates.
Okay, PFC, protein, fats, and carbohydrates.
So imagine your plate, a third protein, a third fat, a third carbohydrate. So the very simple thing is at lunch and at dinner now, make sure that you focus on that you're getting your proteins in, which could be your beef, your fish, your chicken, third of your plate. Your carbohydrates would be your grains or your fruits or your veggies. And then your fats could be salad dressing, avocado. So you start thinking about, and the 8-week challenge will help you with this, but start thinking about eating small, frequent meals. Protein, fat, carbohydrates every 3 hours will balance your blood sugar, just like when you were a baby. So mindset, food.
Okay, mindset first, because that's where it starts with.
1% and then changes.
Then the PFC on your plate, okay? And what would be the third thing? What do they do if they slip? Like, so let's say they walk through an airport and they grab something that isn't so good, then they give up. So you want to show them how to, it's that 1%, like stay focused.
That's the mindset. The third would be balance.
Balance, okay.
So what I would invite everyone right now is focus on is that as you look at your business, as you look at your relationships, as you look at your lifestyle, you gotta ask yourself, why isn't your health equal to that? So think about things that when you look at what you're doing with your business, where can you take maybe 5 minutes here, 10 minutes there, and give it back to your health a little bit? The reason why people fall off for it is because they go all in and then they
set themselves up for failure,
so it's
right?
It's always gotta be, you can't have a perfect quadrant, you can't be perfectly balanced in life, but you can steal back your time. So it's going in with the right mindset, implementing the understanding of the 8-week challenge so you understand how to win with your food and for you and your family, and then realizing that your health needs to be a priority. And it's not about what you look like in the scale or what you look in the mirror, what you weigh on the scale. It's about what you get from your health, and all of that comes.
All right, so, and that's one of the things that made you so successful, right? I mean, just last night, you were what, in Hollywood at the Dolby Theater, presenting to thousands of people?
I had my Oscar moment with my son, Hunter. So we were, but I mean, what's been cool, you know, when I'm in Brazil, I'm in front of 20,000 people.
Right.
So but I still remember where I started.
Right.
I started like this, working with one person.
Yeah, entrepreneurs, leaders, and so forth.
And that's the key. We always, I think as an entrepreneur, you always have to remember where you started. Yeah. Never forget the beginning. and always continue delivering that message. And remember that with your health. As I've worked with so many business professionals, and you being an athlete,
right.
A lot of times athletes, what ends up happening, and many entrepreneurs were former athletes,
right.
You're not, what you did as an athlete, you're not doing anymore. So you have to shift your mindset. You can't go back to what you were doing.
Yeah, I was training 40 hours a week, and I remember telling somebody, well, I went to the Olympic Training Center and I was a pro cyclist, and they're like, used to bees don't make no honey, you know?
It's exactly.
Like, okay, what am I gonna do now, you know?
And so there was a gap with your food.
Yeah.
You were using exercise to stay lean. Food is the foundation. If you can balance your blood sugar, you will never regress. And then that's the power with entrepreneurs. We teach you how to eat on the road. We teach you how to, three places you have to own your food: home, at work, and on the go. Whether you're traveling,
that's so true.
Or whether you're in restaurants.
Yeah, because at home, I definitely eat well, organic foods, that's it. But it seems to be the road. That's the challenges. Yeah. And, you know, so I'm really looking forward to your 8-week challenge. I'd encourage everybody to sign up for the 8-week challenge with Mark, because I mean, you know, it's a shame he doesn't have any energy, right, everybody? So this
well,
is great.
Well, you're gonna learn something called the Mobile Readiness Food Kit.
All right, tell me about that. Tell me about that.
So the MRFK is the best. So like I said, you have your home, you have your work, you have your go.
On the go.
So when I was just in LA, or let's say when I went to Rome 2 months ago.
Right.
So I have my little coolers, and I have my grab-and-go proteins, my grab-and-go fats, my grab-and-go carbs. In the past 2 years, I've been at 6 continents, 50 countries. I can bring my food anywhere. And
that's
whenever
fantastic.
I go, I can always get a good breakfast. I can always get a good dinner. It's the in-betweens that become hard. And like, well, even when I was in Hollywood, 2 days ago, you know, I just go to a restaurant and I say, where's my protein? Where's my fat?
Yeah, you put that and you divide it by 3 and you have the PFC,
exactly.
Right?
Okay. And then you're the boss when you eat out. I think we forget that.
Yeah, that's true.
And then also I'm not a drinker, but if you like some alcohol, there's little adjustments you can make. You get your protein, you get your fat, and instead of having the rice and the potatoes, you can put the alcohol instead of that. So these are the strategies that empower you that when you're on business, meetings, business dinners, you have a solution.
So going back to your business as an entrepreneur, you're obviously changing the world. You've got a whole movement. You know, millions of people follow you. So what do you say to that person who's just on the fence that wants to do more? Talk to me about the mindset. How do you help somebody that might be skeptical and say, well, there's the keto diet and there's the fasting and there's so much information out there that contradicts. I mean, it's kind of like you watch one news channel or another news channel, there's two different stories and the same thing. So tell me about the mindset. Like, what can a leader do to really
I think there's three questions that you got to ask yourself. Number one, is a program I'm going to do based on the science of my body? Number two, would I put a child on it? And number three, can I make this a lifestyle? So you talk about keto.
Right.
I have a 13-year-old son. My son's not doing a keto. My 3-year-old daughter's not doing a keto. So ketogenic diets were created for a very simple thing. So your body processes glucose to make your body's energy source called ATP. Just like how gas fuels a car, glucose creates ATP that fuels your body. Ketos were created for kids who could not process glucose.
I see.
So, and then people saw that, wait a second, it helps you lose weight. The problem though, there's only 3 nutrients to provide you with energy: protein, fats, and carbs. If you remove a food group, the moment you bring it back in, you get bloated. So anyone can lose weight. So you gotta go back to the basics. Is it
based on the
science of my body? Would I put
a
child on it? If you want to put a child on it, it's not right. You're not gonna fast a child. We know that. Every study shows that you need to eat breakfast. Intermittent fasting, you don't eat breakfast. And number three, can I do for the rest of my life? So you gotta ask yourself, do I wanna fast for the rest of my life? Do I wanna cut carbs out for the rest of my life? No, it comes back down to making your health, it's work every single day. Being a parent is hard work. Being married is hard work. Building a business is hard work. But the juice is worth the squeeze. What you get from it is everything. And that's what your health has to be able to. You have to keep asking yourself, how great do I want to be? It's not, I can't promise you're going to live forever.
Right.
But the quality of your life is what matters.
So I've heard this thing about this 7-day detox. Tell me, what is that about?
Yeah, so to me, the 8-week plan, we have a detox. So 7 days of detox in your body, not starving yourself.
Right.
But we remove some of the foods that cause bloating in your body. Mm-hmm. So you're still doing PFC everything, but super clean protein, fats, and carbs.
Wonderful.
And that 7-day detox cleans out your body. You then move into a night phase where we really rev up your metabolism and turn your body into a fat-burning, muscle-building machine. And then after the first 4 weeks, so you make this 30-day run, then the last 4 weeks is all about teaching you how to take that progress and evolve your program into a way of life called thriving.
Well, this has been excellent. I really appreciate you being part of GLO and, of course, sponsored by Microsoft. And I'd encourage all of you to check out the 8-week challenge and check out Mark McDonald. Obviously, you're probably already following him now. And any final words that you'd give an entrepreneur that you want to leave the leaders with today?
Yeah, the best thing that I would share would be this. Get clear on why your health matters. You know, I grew up watching, I share my mom as a chronic dieter, but my wife, Abby, in 1999, had an impact injury and she was diagnosed with fibromyalgia. And we saw her health deteriorate over a year period of time. And there was a moment in our relationship where she lost hope. And I said, babe, we gotta fight. And she started fighting for her health. So a lot of what I teach, a lot of my first book, Body Confidence, was designed, centered around that work that Abby and I did that now we've been able to help millions of people with. You can control your health. You can be your best again. You just always have to keep hope with that and get clear on the why behind it. We get so focused on the external that we forget about that anchor, that when life shows up, that as Ford, as you said, you fall right off, you will fall off, but what's gonna get you back on plan? And for me every day, it's so I can be the best dad, the best husband, and the best leader. So it's the results always come, but it's that why that always keeps me moving forward when that storm comes. So make sure you're clear on that, and then you're gonna win with your health.
Well, thanks so much. Now, I know he's a hugger, so I'm giving him a hug.
Come here,
all right, thanks. It's incredibly easy to become so focused on your business that your health falls to the wayside. Mark shared some excellent methods for fighting back and being active, all while growing your business. I specifically liked his 3 steps to staying fit and healthy. And hopefully you found something to take away and use in your life and business. I know I did. Thank you for watching, and I can't wait to see you on the next episode.